have to be practically tuned. For that, we have to make 5 T's. Who is our target? Immediate target, immediate target, remote target. And what is the time frame that is required? Who is the team which is going to work on it? And what is the technique and what are the tools? So, target, tool, techniques, time, and the team, we have to properly describe, and taking this as an opportunity to frame the skeleton on which we have to wrap it with the flesh and blood, then with skin, then with spirit, then with soul, and make it to execute. So this is a preliminary schedule in which we are going to discover the possibilities of getting into the process of molding these 5 T's gradually, slowly, but effectively. And this is what we call the model plan for the spiritualization as well as the nationalization of the society. And what do you mean by this nationalization? I told about nationals and the various levels of impact on the society possible in future. Nationalization is of 4 types. One is internal, second is indigenous, third is integral, and fourth is international. And the so-called, the first, what we call that internal nationalism is to be very much associated with the fragments of the land, the customs, traditions, by wearing the robes, by wearing the marks, by following the essence of philosophy and way of life of our land. What is our ontology? What is our teleology? What is the axiology? And what is the structure of the human network and their functional status and destinational system in our geomechanics, in our prescribed or demarcated geomechanics of the traditional scriptural and spiritual lineage of our land. So this is known as internal, that deals with something religion, philosophy, etc. Second is indigenous, that deals with something more than that. That deals with our own produce, distribution, our local development, our integrity and strengths. The third thing is integral, which makes us to associate with other lands, connected lands, related lands, permeated lands, and other radiant, homogeneous, statusful lands and people, and to create a totalitarian, strong structure and powerful structure for our land is integral approach. What we are having as worldwide network for our traditions, customs, beliefs and practices. Fourth thing is international. International is entirely different. To get equivalence, to get hypervalence and excellence in science and technology, energy systems, in moral superiority, and also in supremacy, in technicality, in global renaissance, and also as a forerunner and pioneer for values like brotherhood, fraternity, tolerance, and organizing everything under one umbrella. So these things are known as international views. So we are having innumerable such views in this society. And there is others, you know, that wherever there is the solution will be succeeded only by a problem, and each and everything is inbuilt with lot of problems and challenges. Likewise, we are also having a paradoxical debate or a combat in all of these systems. Even in this so-called nationalism, we used to see that. The number one thing is, it is a parallel combat of urban and rural development. Second thing is the combat between the tolerance level of modernity or the so-called fashion and developments or modification in the society, along with the values, heritage, and ethical principles of the land. This is the second parallel combat. And the third parallel combat is between eradicating the basic social evils of poverty, illiteracy, unemployment, and insecurity, and at one end it is industrial development, science and technology development, new inventions of biomedical engineering in the form of elixirs, chlorine, and other, so many other bioethical conversions. So we have lot of things being faced from either side. One is on advanced level, second is on grassroots level. Simultaneously, we have to develop trade, tourism, and international relations and fraternity. At the same time, we have to consider also about various other specialized issues like space engineering and nuclear power engineering. So innumerable things are there that is connected with human, that is connected with human advancement, that is connected with the preliminary step, that is connected with the ultimate step, or scientifically or technically ultimate step. So there is a parallel combat or this dualism always going on. That's why somebody asked a question, why we are doing this Chandrayaan in spite of not promoting the welfare of the rural people, innumerable people that are in the infant mortality rate, lot of people are in malnutrition, lot of people are more illiterate in the society, and why there is an imbalance or a paradoxical governance of one high-end extremity on one side, and one side it is an inferior extremity which makes the normal people or the so-called basic grass members of the society to be totally trampled under insufficiency and paucity. Why it is done so? So, in order to nationalize all the students or all the vigilant members of the society, even the commons, they have to understand few basic principles. Nation, it represents two things. One, it represents the collective quantitative population of a society. Number two, specifically, it refers only to those who are structurally, functionally connected and committed to the development or existence mechanism of the nation. For example, in a school's register, we cannot include lizards and cockroaches only for the reason that they are also in the school campus. Likewise, a lot of people in the society, those who are not connected in the executive or the developmental mechanism, they are not qualitatively connected with the count or the so-called methodology of taking the census of validity of a national standard. Apart from this, the representation of various members of the society, knowingly or unknowingly, as a wonder or blunder, they must have selected somebody to rule. And that selected committee, that will represent the nation. So the third representation, that is the government, it is just designated by the term nation. And whenever a country is having political stability, there only nationalization is possible and nationalization is assurable. So political assurance, that gives social assurance, and social assurance in turn, with proper vigilant and meticulous care and election, that brings political stability. So politics is the base for everything, and somehow unfortunately, just as great people told, lot of unwanted elements, they grow only by the negligence and subservience of the so-called noble and honest members of the society. Dishonesty is nourished only by the ignorance, subservience and negligence of the innumerable committed or to be committed members of the society. So political stability is very much important, and there may be a question, what is the use of the students or anybody thinks that getting into politics is nothing but one more personification of rascaldom or something else which is unusual or dangerous to one's own ethical or social state. It is not like that. Active politics is of two types. One is getting into positions, ruling, establishing the throne, and verification of possibilities of being rethroned and continuously being thrown. These things are one part of active politics. The second thing is to properly select a person, number one, to integrate people for proper selection, number two, to watch that the rule is proper or not, number three, to demand whatever you want, number four, and to seek for a judicial favor or justice if the things are not done, and dethrone the person in the next thing. These six things are the commitments of all people. It is also the part of active politics in which students should take rule. And it creates a healthy social mechanism and makes a salubrious political system. That is number one. Number two, we must be very much proud of our heritage. Generally, nationalism is the four things. More productivity inside the nation. Number two, local distribution and assuring happiness of the inhabitants of the land. Number two. Number three, being proud of our own culture. Number four, love and respect for all. These four qualities are the qualities of nationalism. The third quality is to be proud of our own culture. How do we explain or how do we expect that the proud or the so-called heritage pride mechanism should be? There are four things. You proclaim that your system is proud. You preach to others with the logics, rationale and applications that your system is something which is having innate and inexhaustible pride. Number three, apart from the preaching, you also establish in the society by practice. That is the third point. Number four, whenever there is a blemish, irrational blemish on your pride, protest. Legally, non-violently protest against it and restore the glory of the land. So, proclaiming the glory, preaching the glory, and practicing the glory so that I'm seeing that everybody should try to imitate it and try to envy on your standards. Preach and practice it and protest it non-violently when there is even the slightest possibility of any blemish on it. This is known as real nationalism. So, we have to explain to the society what is the significance of your heritage, what is the meaning of your heritage, what is the meaning of your heritage, each and everything. And what is the significance in each and everybody's life? Number three, what is the relevance of